We all use arrows in PowerPoint to create our diagrams. But unfortunately, most beginners know just one way of drawing these arrows. They go to Autoshapes gallery, from lines they pick up this arrow tool, and then they draw their arrows like this. In this video, I'll show you the different ways you can draw these arrows so you can create your custom arrows and make your diagrams really shine. I'm Ramgopal from presentationprocess.com. We share creative PowerPoint ideas to help professionals like you create engaging presentations. The first thing you can do to make your arrows look a little different is to change the line type. Here is a simple arrow with default line type. I can right click on this arrow, go to Format Shape, go to Fill, Line, and I can change the compound type. So instead of this single line, I can have a compound line like this. So quickly you can see that we have a different look and feel to the arrow. If I want to change that to say something like this, I can do so. These different line types are not just for aesthetic purposes, but can also be used to differentiate the different types of flow whenever you want to create a technical diagram. Now let me go back to the regular type and let me change the dash type this time. Instead of the usual single straight line, I can use a dashed line like this, and this has a different purpose in your diagrams. Now if I want to change this to something like this, I can do so, and you can see that we have this dash type, but each one looks like a square. If I want to have this all looking like a circular dot, I can do so by changing the cap type. Let me go here, instead of flat, I can do round, go to join type and say round again, and you can see that this one has a different look and feel. Normally, you use this style to create timeline diagrams like this. But then, how did we change the end type to this large circle? That brings me to the second way in which you can manipulate your arrows, and that is by changing the arrow heads. PowerPoint allows you to change the arrow heads to suit your specific requirements. For that, let me once again go to the same pane, right click, Format Shape, Fill, Line, and here you can see that I can change my begin arrow type and end arrow type. The begin type can be a simple straight line like this one, or it can be an arrow to create an instant double-headed arrow, or I can change this to a different arrow type, so you can see that this one is different from this. Once again, has a different meaning whenever you create your diagram, or you can have one of them being this circle, that is the dot that I showed you in my earlier timeline diagram. The same way, you can adjust the end arrow type as well, and you can have a different looking arrow. Of course, at any point of time, you can change the size of these arrow heads by going to this begin arrow size. If you want it really large like this, you can do so, or if you want it really small like this, you can do so. And all of this gives you complete control in the way you want your arrow to be. The one option that even experienced users of PowerPoint are not aware is it is possible for you to change the elbow connector in your arrows. Let me show you what I mean by that. Let me go to this basic arrow. If I want to change the elbow connector type, I can right click on this and go to this connector type, and I can use something like this connector elbow. You can see that at the face of it, it looks like the same arrow. But here, if I move to this end and then move it, you can see that the arrow moves in a very different way. The same way, if I want to change the connector type to something else, like go to connector types and change it to curved connector, you can do so, and this can also be adjusted. So if you want to represent a concept like multiple things are flowing into one area, you can do so by taking this and then by pressing Ctrl D to create a duplicate, and then let us have it flip vertical. So we have a different way of representing this. Once again, press Ctrl D, and this time I don't really want the connector type to be like any of these. I'm going to have the straight connector, and I can move this over here. I can change the angle, and I can represent that three of these are flowing into one destination. Now let us move to something even more interesting, and that is how to draw your own arrows. Here I am on a blank slide. First, let me show you how you can draw a circular arrow. For that, let us go to Autoshapes gallery. From basic shapes, I'm going to use this one called as arc tool. I can hold the shift button down and I can draw an arc like this. Holding the shift button down allows me to have a circular arc like this, and this allows me to have my arrow in whichever angle I want. For example, I can select this, increase the weight like this, and change the color. And if I want to have an arrowhead, I can do so quite nicely. Earlier, I showed you that you just need to right click, go to fill, go to line, and you can change the begin arrow type to something like this. And you can see we have a nice looking curved arrow. You can always manipulate it the way you want. And this is quite useful to create circular process diagrams. Another way is to draw your own curved line and then make it into an arrow. Let me delete this. Let me once again go to Autoshapes gallery. From lines, I'm going to pick up this option here called curve. And let me draw a curve like this. You can see it's a very interesting way in which you can represent the movement in a zigzag pattern. And this is the curved line. Once again, as we did before, we are going to have this increased in weight, and I can change the end arrow type by going to this one and use this option. And you can see that we have a nice looking arrow that represents the zigzag movement. And if I put an animation here by using a simple wipe animation from left, it really animates quite nicely. Let me increase the duration like this to say around 2 seconds. See how this line draws itself. So you can represent some very interesting arrows like this by drawing your own curved lines. Even if you want to scribble your own line using the scribble tool in lines, you can do so and convert that into an arrowhead like this. And you can change the end type to something like this. And if I increase the weight like so, you can see that it looks very interesting. So you can pretty much create your own arrows in the way you want by drawing the curves or scribbles and converting them into arrowheads. Another way you can create your arrows is by combining different auto shapes. Let us go to Auto Shapes gallery. From basic shapes, let us pick up this tool called as the moon tool, and let me draw a moon like this. I can cut this into half by picking up a rectangle and then using that as a way to cut this. So let me select this first, hold the shift button down and then select the rectangle, and then go to shape format, merge shapes and say shape subtract. Now I can add a triangle here and make this into an arrow. Once again, let me go to Auto Shapes gallery. Let us pick this triangle and then I can change the direction like this and I can place it over here. Select both of them, go to shape format, merge shapes and say shape union. Now I have my own custom shaped arrow created by merging different shapes. The same way, if I want to go to Auto Shapes gallery once again, and let me choose a different type. For example, I can choose this one, which is the hall frame, and I can draw a hall frame like this and then combine it with a chevron shape. For example, I can find in block arrows this chevron shape. I can select this and then draw it and then turn it around, place it over here, and I can make multiple copies of this and then place it one below the other, and I have a different looking arrow here. So you can play with different auto shapes to create your own arrows. Of course, once you create a shape like this, you can create duplicates of that and come up with some interesting diagrams that look like this. So anything is possible as long as you apply a bit of creativity. Another thing you can do with the arrows is to alter the shapes of the arrowheads. Let me show you what I mean by that. Let us go to Auto Shapes gallery. From block arrows, let me pick up this chevron shape. Now, this is the default way the arrow looks. Now, if I want to change this arrowhead, all I need to do is to right click on this, go to edit points. I can select this and delete it. And I can select this one and delete it. Now we have a different looking arrowhead. Even if you want to change the yellow handles, you can do so. Let us go to Auto Shapes gallery. From block arrows, let us pick up a different arrow type. So this is the arrow type I want to choose. I can make it look very different by adjusting these yellow handles. I can move this, and this one looks very different from the default one that we started out with. Now, the final trick is you can get even more arrow types than the ones that are available in Auto Shapes gallery by stealing the arrow types from SmartArt. We all know that when we go to Auto Shapes gallery from block arrows, we can choose these different types of arrows to draw. Do you know that it is possible for you to pick some more arrows from SmartArt? Let me show you what I mean by that. Let us go to Insert, go to SmartArt. Let me go to process and let us say I want to use this arrow here. I can select this and say OK. Now this is an interesting smart art. If I want to change the color, I can do so. Maybe I can choose something like this and I can have just this as the arrow picked out from SmartArt. For that, let me select this, go to convert and say convert to shapes, right click and go to group and say ungroup. We don't really want any of these. I can delete it. Now I can select all of this and press Ctrl G. I can use this arrow wherever I want. The same way, let us choose a different SmartArt diagram by going to insert, SmartArt, and let us choose process. And this time I want to use a different arrow like this, and I can say okay. Now I can convert this into shape and right click and ungroup. Now I just want to take this arrow and press Ctrl X and remove everything else by selecting and deleting them. And let me get it back by pressing Ctrl V. Now I can change the color of this and I can manipulate the size, shape and the width of this arrow stem to suit my requirement. You can see that this kind of an arrow is not available anywhere in your Autoshapes gallery with these kind of options to change the nature of the arrow. See, there is so much you can learn about something as simple and mundane as arrows in PowerPoint. PowerPoint is so full of such limitless possibilities that most presenters are not aware of, even if they have been using the program for years. If you want to learn PowerPoint the right way and explore the full potential of the program, then I highly recommend that you join our PowerPoint Foundation course that can really help you understand the limitless potential of PowerPoint. I will leave a link to this useful program in the description box below the video. So go ahead, click on the link in the description box below the video and explore the true potential of PowerPoint and become a PowerPoint champion in your organization.